Crazy turn of events. Anthony Joshua loses by stoppage to Andy Ruiz, and we have a new and the first ever heavyweight champion of Mexican descent, Andy Ruiz Jr. What a crazy turn of events that I did not see coming at all. Going into this fight, I expected Anthony Joshua to win around a 10th round TKO, whatever it may have been. I expected AJ to somewhat jab him about, keep him at a certain distance, break him down piece by piece, and then at the end probably find a big opening and then put him away. Andy Ruiz showed his ability, get in on the inside, stay there, and show his great hand speed. His hand speed is something that truly impressed me. I didn't really realize how fast he was up until he was against like fighting somebody like Anthony Joshua, who's not really the fastest of punchers to begin with. So if he can go in there and just display that type of speed against AJ, that was something that I just didn't see coming. And it was clear as days that Anthony Joshua was not ready to be able to deal with somebody of Andy's structure, height, and reach. But his speed, his ability to get in on the inside, stay in the inside, and work was something that AJ hasn't seen. Like, he just didn't see it coming. And the shots that really caught him, that dropped AJ, like, in the first few times, was those quick, short punches that were right around the ear area, around the temple, that shook him up, and Andy Ruiz just goes in for the finish. And the ability, for Andy Ruiz to be able to stay calm, composed, go all the rounds, and not blow himself out was just the key. Andy Ruiz could have easily went out loud in the fourth round after getting the two knockdowns in the third. He could have easily done that, but no, he didn't. He stayed composed, and he knew that his moment was going to come. Seemingly, Anthony Joshua caught him. You know, he kind of recovered in the fourth round, and going into the fifth round, he was landing his hooks, his lead hook, his jabs a bit more convincingly. However, one thing that always stayed consistent was Anthony Joshua. His jab was always kind of getting slipped. It was always getting parried. And as soon as it got parried and Andy Ruiz was able to get very close with AJ and trade it out, right? Those are the moments where he dropped him in the third round. And then going into the last round, the seventh round, that was just a bit too much. By that point, Anthony Joshua got dropped like three times already. And then like in the seventh, I think it was like another five. So in total, Anthony Joshua got dropped five times. And the referee, you know, he knew that Anthony Joshua was not completely out of it, but he did spit out his mouth guard, and like he just had seen enough. Andy Ruiz was probably going to go in there and get a finish over Anthony Joshua, regardless if he went in there and, you know, continued on in that round. This was definitely Andy Ruiz's night. Amazing performance by Andy Ruiz. He showed that with the quote-unquote disadvantages that he has in terms of height and reach, whatever it may have been, he did know how to make it work. And Anthony Joshua was just not ready to fight somebody of Andy Ruiz's just structure, build. It was just something that he did not see coming. Hand speed was lightning fast, combination punches that really caught Anthony Joshua off guard, and really just it messed him up. And he finally got put down, he got put away. And the new IBF, WBO, and the WBA heavyweight champion of the world, Andy Ruiz Jr., which seems very, very crazy to think about. Congratulations to Andy Ruiz. Tremendous performance. What a night of boxing. What do you guys think? What will happen next, and who will win in the rematch? Leave it all in the comment section down below. As always, I have been Keenan from Keenan KTV, signing off. Later.